Good morning. It is, I don't know, about 5:25 in the morning. Tuesday, December 5th. Vlogmas, day 5, 2023. My name's Karina. I'm walking out to the barn on a very rainy morning. It has warmed up a lot. It is about 55 degrees, so it'll be interesting to see if how much the creek has come up, because I don't know how much it rained last night. This creek normally stays in its banks, still quite below the culvert there. It's running pretty fast though. There's the house and the Christmas tree, and here's the barn. So the horses are probably going to get mostly a day off today from any training, although I do have something in mind for Braggy today, and I'll see if I can capture that on film. It has to do with asking him to stand by a marker and wait, and this is all part of the trailer training that my trainer and I are doing. A very long walk out to the barn, but I'm already wet. I see the horse's eyeballs out there. I don't know. There's O. All right, I'm gonna get to feeding. I will see you soon. Trying to set this up. So this is a station for Braggy, and I'm using positive reinforcement. I'm using the cone to show him where I want him to wait until I give him the signal. And I want him to target that cone and wait till I tell him to go. So this is the morning. Okay, he just touched it. He gets another treat for that. This is the morning release. And what I'm trying to prevent is him rushing up to the gate. And I also want to show him where to wait. So this is going to come in handy with trailer training, so that he will wait by the cone. And hopefully, the idea is that I put the cone in the horse trailer and he will wait by it. So he's done that really well. Good job, buddy. So now I am going to, and I don't know if I can do this in film at the same time, I'm gonna ask him to leave. And I'm just using my stick to encourage him. Good job. No, he loves the cone, which was kind of the idea. Come on, buddy. Good job. And turn around and face me. Good work. And now. Hi, everyone. I thought I'd share my workspace with you. I'm in the basement. My computer screens, and then this window looks out under the deck toward the creek. When the barn lights are on, I can see the barn in the morning, but the trees are just really too thick to see very much. I don't know if you know, there's too much reflection. You can see under the deck. So I'm getting into my third hour of work. So I will take a break later and talk to you about knitting and knitted garment I am wearing. So I'll see you then. Hi again, everyone. This will be the final segment of day 5 of Vlogmas 2023. It is December 5th, which is a Tuesday. And I have already started my day with my knitting, and I showed you the progress I had made on the Nutcracker Advent Sock Knit Along by Kay Jones, and I will have the details about that in the show notes. The podcast Kay Jones is part of is the Bakery Bears, and I will have a link to that. And then I took you along when I went to feed the horses at, I think that was 5:30-ish this morning. And then I showed you, and I don't remember, right now I don't remember which order. Did I show you some work first, or did I show you like a really short training session I did with Braggy when I was letting the boys out from their breakfast, individual breakfast feeding arrangement? So that's where we're at. I am working today. And I'm on a short break right now just to finish this. I made myself a cup of tea, so I thought I would just finish out this video. So, what I'm wearing today. This is the Rocket Tee by, I think it's Tanis Designs. I will have a link to that in the show notes. It's a top-down V-neck. The V-neck is knitted flat, and then you join raglan shape, and then you just knit. It's down to the bottom. It has an I-cord bind-off at the bottom. This is a bit oversized, which is fine since weather here in Northwest Washington is often on the cooler side. I have worn this as a tee with a tank top underneath it in the summertime. I don't really care for it as much. For one thing, it's surprisingly warm for fingering weight. It's fingering weight yarn held with mohair, and I used it was a very light color of fingering weight, a neutral color really. It held with, I think, kind of a lavenderish mohair. So it is warm, so it's perfect for a atmospheric river day that we're having today. So it's warm. It was about 55 or so degrees this morning when I went out to feed the horses, and raining, and it's probably about the same now. So I was just thinking about terminology. I watched some young YouTubers, and one of them, I don't think she does it anymore, but it was called Knitting in the Dark, and it was a young couple in North Carolina, I think. And she would talk about the way she styled her knitted garments, and I just thought about that because the way I phrase things is, well, what I'm wearing, and I'm wearing this with this, but I suppose it is a style. So I'm kind of trying to adopt that language. I'm not sure if I will. I don't know that I really have a style per se. The person, I think her name is Marie, who did this vlog. She definitely has a style. She wears almost exclusively dark colors. Black, I believe, is her favorite, and she has kind of a goth hairstyle and makeup, where my style, on the other hand, is that my hair is hair, and it is its natural color and natural state, except when I have it in a braid. And I haven't worn makeup for probably, I don't know, close to 40 years. So that is my style. Maybe it's a non-style. In any event, the way that I styled this Rocket Tee was to wear a turtleneck under and a jacket, which, I think it makes it appropriate for casual work. I do work from home, but I still dress for work. So if any of you think that I work in my pajamas, I only do that if I am working non-business hours. So if I am expecting to conduct some business, I am always appropriately dressed. So all that to say, shall we get on with knitting progress? Like I said, I already showed you the progress of the Advent sock. I want to show you a non-knitting or a non-Advent progress that I've made. I've been working on this Riverside sweater pullover by, it's inspired by Sophia Loren movie. It's Riverside Pullover when we get to the page. This is what it looks like. It is from Silver Screen Knits, Volume 2. I am almost certain it was a free pattern. And it's silverscreenknits.com. And I have a feeling this little piece of sticky tape was something important. So it is probably, but I think I know where I was. I'm actually on the yoke. And I'm changing up the colors a bit. So, I am supposed to knit 9 rounds. Oh, here we go. Here it is. Okay, I'll put it back where it belongs so I don't lose track. So, as I've explained before, here is the sweater with the sleeves attached. So, isn't this fun? So, the main color is supposed to be this naturally colored kind of gray-brown. It's in the colorway Truffle. It is a local yarn, as is this neutral color that is also from the same sheep farm that is local to my area. Skagit Valley Yarns, I believe, is the mill. And then the red is a Pattens. It's a, you know, commercially dyed yarn. It's a Pattens. This is all worsted weight. So I suppose I didn't think about this very hard, which is typically the way that I approach knitting projects. I was thinking that this sweater was going to be more brown. Excuse me. Kind of have the little bit of the hiccups. It's a bottom-up pattern. Everything's all curled up. Started with contrast color 1, which is the red, and then went to the main color, I hope you can see that, which is the truffle, and then contrast color 2 is the white, which is, I don't remember what that's called. I want to say it's marshmallow, but that doesn't sound right. I think that's a different yarn that I'm talking to. I'm starting to change things up a little bit. I want this sweater to be more brown. And I'm worried about playing a little yarn checking with the red. So where, actually, I will show you. Oh, here's the beginning of the round. It's behind one of the sleeves that I just attached. So I'm supposed to do 9 rounds of the contrast color 1, but that is a lot more red. I'm going to do 9 rounds of the main color because I have a lot of yarn in that color. I am going to eventually undo the ribbing on these sleeves and make the sleeves longer and smaller in diameter. I don't mind that this is oversized because I typically wear a lot of layers, but I do want the sleeves to be somewhat fitted and probably go down to about bracelet length. So that's what I'm going to do. I will have to undo the ribbing on both, and then I will start the decreases. And chances are I am going to alternate probably like these color change rows and do some striping and then end up with ribbing. I think it depends on what ribbing color I end up with at the neckline. I don't think I'm going to do red ribbing at the neckline. So it's either going to be this lighter color that I'm not remembering what they're calling the colorway or the truffle. I'm guessing the truffle because I have so much of that yarn. So I'm going to stuff that back into its bag. It's quite a large bag. My sister-in-law gave this bag to me for Christmas some years ago when I started knitting. And it's been a great bag for this project. So here's the pattern. Oh, look, here is the yarn label up front. So maybe I can tell you what that color is. And if you want to, you can pull from these slits on top, which is also a great amusement for the kitties. So I keep it kind of out of their reach. So the farm is Harmony Fields. The yarn producer is Skagit Valley Yarns. This is the label for truffle, which is that gray-brown color. This one, hopefully, is the lighter color. Fromage. Oh, gosh. Marshmallow. Marshmallow fromage. Fromage being French for cheese, if you were not aware. So that is that. So other Advent knitting, I haven't made a ton of progress on it, so I'm not showing it. I made a little bit of progress on the scarf that I'm working on, the Colorwork scarf. I started a Colorwork section last night. I don't know if I picked a color that is contrasty enough with the main color, so I may end up ripping that out. I will see. I'm going to knit a little bit more on it and see how it goes. The motif that I'm working on right now is a reindeer. So very cute, but I use kind of a lavender color, which may not, and the main color is a neutral, very pale neutral color. So I may end up ripping that out. So, and the other one I'm working on is a shawl that is using the Polka Dot Creek mini bouquet, Advent bouquet that has 24 colors in it. I am still on section 3, so I'm a couple, officially a couple days behind now. So not a huge priority. I mean, the colors aren't particularly Christmassy. The shawl isn't particularly holiday spirit, so I'll just work on that at my leisure. What I did get, however, is the yarn for the Arne and Carlos stocking knit along. So I may prioritize that along with the sock and along with this sweater. The other work that I have on hold is the Stephen West MCAL from October. It's a shawl. I was looking at Knit All the Yarn podcast shawl the other day. She wore it in, I think, her Monday's podcast. And you know, I'm kind of thinking I'm getting close to being done. I'm almost done with the section 2 of it, and that seems like it's the majority of the length. And then there's, it looks like some other edging sections. So, what did I get? I ordered the yarn. I got the Norwegian wool, which is a DK weight, in their recommended colors. So the red, white, and green. I wonder if this color is marshmallow. I wonder if that's where it got. I don't think so. I think it's Cloud Dancer, emerald, and then and this is red. So I may start working on that. I have needles for it. I just opened the package yesterday. I bought needles for it because I love these size. These are Addi, which are made in Germany. 3.25 millimeter needles and 3.5. So, this might be the right size for my shawl. So after I do whatever, so I may do some needle switching around, because if you remember from a previous episode yesterday or the day before, I was having trouble with the magic loop because the cord wasn't long enough on the needles I was using, so I may do a little switching around. I'm going to put this project in a project bag, which is the one that my mom made me. Got to get the other stuff out of it. I use this for a sock bag a lot. So this is another quilted bag that mom made me with a drawstring top, which I really enjoy because I don't get yarn caught in the zipper. So I am going to put this yarn and these needles in here, and maybe this afternoon during another break or lunchtime, maybe some lunchtime knitting, I will work on that. So that is the knitting, the Advent knitting and the regular knitting that I've been up to. And I've been rather long-winded this Vlogmas compared to last year. I think last year my Vlogmas videos were like 3 to 5 minutes, I'm a lot more long-winded now. So I'm going to end that here. Happy Vlogmas day 5, and I'll see you tomorrow.